Have you been brewing your own kombucha, but you don't know how to get it fizzy like the stuff that you buy in the store? Or maybe you want it fruit flavored too. You know, that stuff that you buy at the store is really, really good. Nice and foamy, fizzy, gets a great head on it. Lots of carbonation, plus it's fruit flavored. So we're gonna show you how to do that. You could go to the store and just buy yourself, you know, like a quart size bottle or a half gallon size bottle of fruit juice, and you could just use that. But my preference, and mostly because it's cheaper, is to just go to Costco and get a bag of blueberries or strawberries or any other organic fruit that they've got frozen. And I just use that. Just put a couple of cups into a nice big pot like this and cover them with hot water. You want about, well, it depends on how much kombucha you're gonna make, but I like to use about a quart of water. And then you just set that on the stove and let it simmer for a while. Don't let the water evaporate out of there though. Just let it simmer for a while, then turn it off. You wanna make sure that it's not hot anymore before you put it into your kombucha. So that gives you the juice that you need without going and spending $7 or $8 for a jar of it from the health food store. The very first thing I do is I pour the kombucha out of my brewing bottle, because I do a continuous brew, into a jar that doesn't have a SCOBY in it. That way you don't have to worry about the SCOBY while you're trying to pour it into the smaller bottles. Now, I still have the blueberries in here, so I'm gonna strain this out. So the first thing that I do is I just pour the juice out of the pot where I simmered the berries into another jar. And I usually like to have, you know, just about maybe a fifth, not so much of a quart, a little bit less than a quart, so about a fifth of the jar filled with the juice. And then I take the kombucha tea and just pour it right into there so it mixes it. If you're a fan of store-bought kombucha, you're gonna recognize these bottles, okay? We'll buy the stuff at the store just so that we can get the bottles, although we do like drinking the stuff that comes in the bottles. But you want a good bottle that's glass. Number one, it has to be glass, not plastic, and it's gotta have a good cap on it that's gonna provide a nice, good seal, because this is your secret to getting the fizzy kombucha. Then all you're gonna do is just put your kombucha into a measuring cup or something with a spout. You can even just put a funnel on top of this and pour it right out of the 1 gallon jar. I find that this is the easiest way to do it. And remember, now this is blueberry flavored kombucha. You can do this with any flavor, but you could also just do it with straight regular kombucha. Now I like to fill it up a little bit higher than this normally, get it really close up to the neck of the bottle and cap it, and set it up in your pantry or set it off into a cabinet, something like that. And usually within 12 to 24 hours, now you've got a great batch of blueberry flavored or whatever flavor you want kombucha that's ready for you to drink, and it's gonna be great fizzy kombucha. So that's it, that's the whole secret. One thing to keep in mind is that these lids for these bottles, if you're getting these recycled kombucha bottles, the plastic lids on them, although they provide a really good seal for quite some time, they do wear out. Just because of the pressure that's built up inside the bottle, they can get cracks on them, and then they don't seal as well. And then your kombucha is more flat. So if you notice that that's starting to happen to you, just go ahead and go get some more kombucha bottles, or just go buy some more kombucha and drink it and keep the bottle. But if you want to save a bunch of money, make your own, and especially if you want the berry flavored and nice carbonated kombucha, this is the way to do it.